family and whatnot here must have felt kind of right at home in a way.
Yeah, I mean, it was awesome to be down in Winnipeg again. Like I said before, I haven't been here for a couple of years.
Right.
COVID changed that, but it was great. My grandparents and mom and sister came out and had some fans out there, signed some autographs for them. So, I mean, it was an unbelievable experience, and I was just happy to be down here.
You know, new to the whole organization, how important was a week like this? Obviously, the on-ice stuff, but even just the off-ice kind of bonding and building relationships.
Yeah, kind of to build off what you just said, I think it was huge. I think meeting the guys, I think that was great. We had a lot of dinners. I think that helped out with that. And just the staff, everyone in the organization, I think it was great to kind of talk to them and see what they're all about. And everyone here is super nice, and it just feels like I belong here and they want me here. So couldn't be at a better place.
How did the escape room go for you?
I mean, our team struggled a bit, but I've done a couple, so it was pretty easy for me. But we got through it at the end. Team effort for sure, so can't take all the credit.
Who was on your team?
It was Lambo, Chaz,
Owen,
Ford. We had a lot of guys.
Right on.
So I mean, it was great. It was super fun for sure.
What's curious for you, like, you know, you come in and everybody's obviously wanting to become a Jet at some point in their career. You guys all have that same bond. I'm curious how that brings you guys all together, because you know, it could be a really competitive atmosphere, but at the same time, you know, I think it was Rucker on the first day said, you know, we're all going to be best friends at some point, so we may as well start now. It's curious how that dynamic kind of plays out.
Yeah, I mean, everyone here is competitive. They want to eventually get to the NHL. And I think it's just the culture they have here. It comes even with the staff down here, too. I mean, everyone just wants the best out of every single kid here, and I think everyone, I mean, we talked about it today in the locker room, what it means to be a good teammate, and I think that's huge. So just going around treating everyone with respect and building those unique relationships, I think it's super important.
What was the theme of the escape room?
It was a Poseidon. It was an underwater thing. It was a little weird, but it was good.
And speaking of just like going forward with the, you know, good attitudes and all that sort of stuff, to watch you guys all come through the fans, people are thanking the fans for being there and stuff like that. Where did that come from? Did you guys talk about how you wanted to interact with everybody? Or?
I mean, yeah, the coaches touched on it at the end there, but I mean, it's been all week thing. They've been down here since the first day of camp, and I think that just shows the support we got down here from people in Winnipeg, and I think it's incredible. I mean, they filled out the rink today, and it was just battle drills. So, I mean, I can't imagine what it's going to be like to play in the rink someday. So, I mean, it was great. And, I mean, you got to show your care and love for them, too, because they're coming out to support you. And I think that's all I have for that.
Yeah. Like, what's the mindset now? You're going to obviously head to the USHL in Sioux Falls for the season, obviously looking just for a really big season down there.
Yeah. I mean, we want to win, and I think that's kind of the goal going into it. But it's going to be fun. I've met a lot of the guys and the staff down there, so it should be great. It's going to be a tough league. It's going to be faster and more physical compared to what I've been used to, but I think the training this summer is going to help, and especially being down here this week, I think it's huge. And just try to win as many games as we can and hopefully win the Clark Cup.
I've heard your game be described as sort of like the Jets said that they were glad that you had a couple of years to just like grow into your strength, grow into all of those sorts of things. Do you see it the same way? What does that mean?
Yeah, for sure. I think even playing against older guys today, I think for me, just filling out my frame and putting on some muscle, I think that's going to be huge for me. I'm a bigger kid, so I think with that strength, it's going to be great for the battles in the corner and stuff. And I think just the experience is huge. The USHL. And then college, it's all going to be great, because as you go up, it's just faster and stronger and more physical. So I think that's going to be huge for me, and I think it'll help a lot to hopefully make an impact for the Jets one day.
And do you also feel like you have a bit of offense to give? Just to watch you here, there seems to be like some pretty strong finishing skills as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, for sure. I think definitely been something I've been working on. And I think it's the goalies only get better as you go up. So I think working on the fundamentals every single day, it's super important. But I think just giving it your best effort and doing the right things every day, I think the goal scoring is going to come, and the offense is going to come from that too.
Zach, what's it like too to get a glimpse of the, you know, first round guys like Colby and Rutger and the guys that are, you know, some from your draft class, some from previous, Brad, Chaz, all these guys.
Yeah,
like, I mean, it's pretty assembled in the same place.
Yeah, it's awesome to experience that. I mean, getting to talk to them and kind of seeing how they go about their business every day and how they are on and off the ice, I think it's cool to just try to see what they do and how I can implement implement some of those things in my own game. But I think it's also good to kind of compare yourself to them and see how much you need to get better, or see how kind of what you are kind of like. And so, I mean, it was great. I think that was good for me and kind of my process down the road. I think it was huge to kind of get a feel for those guys.
I was going to say, a nice resource too, knowing that, you know, Rutgers is kind of going down the path that you're looking to go down yourself. Right?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I met him down in Nashville at the draft and got to talk to him quite a bit this week. So I think it was great. He kind of just talked about what college has been like for him and what he's going to do moving forward. So I think that was kind of cool to try to put myself in his shoes a little bit and see how it relates to my situation.
Now, we get a glimpse of it with Colby and Rutger. They're really outgoing personalities. I mean, what's it like to kind of be around guys that are, you know, being touted as future captains, even at the NHL level?
Yeah, I mean, it's great, and especially those guys. They're such great kids and great characters. So I couldn't want a better leader out of those guys. And I mean, for me, I'm kind of more reserved. I don't open up right away. So I think being around those more extroverted guys and just easygoing people to be around with, I think that's huge for me also. I think it's easier to create relationships with them, and I mean, it's just, they're fun guys to be around, so it's been great.
You mentioned Rutger at the draft. He was in Nashville? Is he part of the... I thought was he also sort of an unofficial Jets welcoming committee?
I don't know. It was cool. I got to meet him right away and his family, so it was great just talking to them, and I mean, the whole day was unbelievable, so it was cool to kind of have someone who's been there before and kind of talk to him about it, so yeah, it was great.
How about the family element, too? I know we were talking with her.
Grandparents and mom and sister
yesterday. What's it like to be able to share a piece of this with them also?
Yeah, I mean, it's awesome. My grandparents are a huge Jets fan, so I mean, kind of just to have that for them, I think they were super excited when they found out I was going to be a Jet. And I think it's also nice and easy for my family to come up and watch. I think it's cool. They came down the last couple of days, and I think just seeing them after I get off the ice is always special. I think it just gives you a reason to work a little harder because they sacrificed so much for me. So to hopefully play in the Jets building one day for them, it'd be unbelievable.
Awesome. It was great meeting you. Enjoy the summer.
Thank you.
One last one. Just about that idea of when last year, if you would have come to Winnipeg to play in a game or play at the Iceplex or whatever, you just would have been Zach Nehring. But now you're Zach Nehring, the Jets prospect. So what does that mean to you to be, you know, have a more meaningful role here in the city?
Yeah. I mean, it's definitely special, and just kind of try to take it all in. I mean, my life's changed quite a bit in the last couple of weeks, but at the same time, there's still a lot of work to do. At the end of the day, it doesn't mean too much. It's just one of those things, background noise. But I mean, it's great. The support from the fans has been unbelievable so far. I'm not going to change who I am. I'm going to try to still be humble about everything and treat everyone the same way. But it's definitely cool, and something I've been dreaming about since I was little.
Thanks, Zach.